George, and this is the 13th episode of my Java programming tutorial series. In this episode, we are going to cover 10 subtopics of the file management topic in Java. Let's get started. First of all, I'm going to show you what kind of topics we are going to cover. So the first will be getting the name of the current directory. The second will be listing the files in the current directory. The third will be listing the directories in the current directory. The fourth will be checking the modification date of a folder. The fifth will be listing all the files in the current folder recursively. The sixth will be creating a new file. The seventh will be deleting a file. The eighth will be renaming a file. The ninth will be creating a folder. And the tenth will be deleting a directory recursively. So if all of that sounds interesting for you, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also click the notification bell and share this video with your friends, colleagues, coworkers, or whoever you know that is interested about the programming topic. Let's get started. So as I said in the beginning of this video, first of all, we are going to get the name of the current directory. For doing that, we can System.out println, a new file. You can enter whatever name you want for it. Do got get absolute file, dot get parent file, dot toString. The next thing what we are going to do will be listing the files in the current directory. So we are going to create a new for loop for file f colon get current dir, and this get current dir will be our method for getting this current dir, what I have shown you how to do previously, but without the toString method, of course. And we are going to call the list files method in this file object. And we can just print out this f. As you can see, this might produce null pointer exception, but we won't really care about that. So let's run the program. As you can see, it listed all the files and the folders as well. But we only need to list the files in this section. So I'm going to create a new file filter and put it inside this list files method as an argument. And we need to implement the accept method of this file filter, which will only accept files if the file is basically a file. So we are going to do path name.isFile. So now if I run the program, then you can see that we can only see these files and we can't see the folders anymore. So now I'm going to list you all the folders in the current directory. It's pretty much the same as we did previously, but instead of doing isFile, we are going to do path name.isDirectory. So as you can see, there are only the directories listed. So the fourth subtopic for our video will be checking the modification date of a folder. For doing that, we need to get the folder of which modification date we would like to check and do dot last modified. This is a long, basically, and it's a UTC time, so we can use the date to print it in a readable form. So let's run the program now. As you can see, I have printed out the row number and the actual date of modification. Let's move to the fifth part now. We are going to list all the files in the current folder recursively. This will be a little bit more complicated than the stuff we did previously, but I hope you will understand it. So we will need to create a new array list and add the files of the current directory to this array list. For that, we are going to create a recursive method and call it addFiles. This addFiles method will basically have two arguments, a file, which will be the directory from which we would like to add the files, and the list of files we have already added. So in this method, we are going to check if this directory is a file. If it is, so it's not a directory, but it's a file, then we are just going to add it to this files list. If it's not a file, but it's a directory, then we are going to use this list files method, basically, and just call this add files recursively on all the files which are returned by this dir.listFiles method. And of course, we are going to create a new for loop here and print all the files we have added to this files list. And as you can see, if I run the program now, you can see all the files recursively printed. So now we are going to create a new file, and our file will be located in the lesson 13. For doing slash, we can do file.separator instead of just using slash. And our file name will be createdFile.txt. For creating the actual file, we are going to use the file output stream. In the previous video, I have already shown you how to use these output streams. So this should be nothing new for you, but it's a really good example for this output stream's actual usage. Not just using it for byte arrays, but for actual files. As you can see in the Java documentation, it said that this file output stream may throw a file not found exception. And this exception is not thrown when the file doesn't exist, because the file which we want to create shouldn't exist. But it's thrown when the file we would like to create have a name, which is basically a name of a directory in that folder, or if we don't have write access to this directory. So we are going to use the try-catch block to catch this exception. I don't think this will be thrown, but just in case. So we are going to write, this is our new file, to the file. And for that we are going to use the FOS, which will be the name of the file output stream variable, .write. This is our new file, .getByte. And of course we need to close the file. However, we can avoid this closing by making the Java automatically close the file after we finished in this try block. For doing that, we need to move this file output stream FOS equals new file output stream to create to the header of the try block. So basically after this bracket. Let's run the program and see if our file is created or not. So as you can see, our file is there and it's created, so this code works properly. And as you can see, if I run the program several times, it will recreate the same file. So for making it basically append to the file, instead of creating a new file, we can put a true argument to the file output stream, which will enable its appending mode, and this will basically just append the new lines to the file. So it's very useful, for example, for log files. And we can run this as many times as we want, and these two new lines will be just added to the file. Alright, so now we can move to the next topic, which will be deleting a file. And deleting a file is super simple. We just need to call this .delete method. So let me run the program now. And as you can see, the created file was deleted. So now we are going to move to the next topic of today's video, which will be renaming a file. Renaming a file should be pretty simple. You just use the .rename2 method and enter the new name of the file, which should be a new file, of course, and should contain the actual directory of the file, plus the file separator and a new file name. So you shouldn't just enter a new file name, but you also need to include this information there. Alright, so as you can see, it got renamed properly. We can, of course, check the result of this renaming process. So if the renaming was successful, then we can print out the rename was successful, and if it wasn't successful, then we can print that it wasn't. As you can see, the rename failed now because we already have a file with this new file name, so if I remove this and we run the program again, then you can see the rename was successful. So of course you can never rename a file to a file name which another file already has. So now we can move to next topic, which will be creating a folder. And for doing that, we can just create a new file, which will be the actual path to the directory, and we can call the mkdirs method, which will create a whole directory structure for this directory. Now I'm going to show you as a bonus, I didn't mention this in the beginning of the video, but I am going to show you another way to write to files, which will be a little bit simpler than the previous one was. This will be using print writers. I'm going to create two print writers now and print that this is the first file message to the first one and that this is the second file to the second one. And let's run the program now, of course. As you can see, the two files were created properly. So now I can show you the last thing what I wanted to show you in this video, which is deleting a directory recursively. And we are going to remove the lesson13.this directory. As you can see, we can't just use this delete method because it shows us that the delete result was false. So we need to loop through all the files, so we need to get all the files and the folders of this directory. And for that I'm going to create a new method, which looks like that. I'm also going to print these files, of course, to see which files were deleted actually. And for each file I will show that the deletion process was successful or failed. As you can see, everything is successful, so yeah, that's the way how you can delete files in the whole directory in Java. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to share it with your friends. Also leave a like and leave a comment about your thoughts about my video or a feedback about what did you learn this video. It's very important for me to get your feedback, so I really appreciate it if you leave a comment right now. Also, if you didn't like this video yet, when I asked you to do so in the beginning of the video, make sure to do it right now. And thank you very much for watching, and I see you in the next video.